With a bowling alley, 3D screens, and a lounge inside, this Movico theater made a big splash when it opened near Fredericksburg 2 weeks ago. But over the weekend, a new employee called attention to something else, a mural being painted on the bar patio featuring a Confederate flag.
As soon as I noticed it, I was immediately shocked that it was being put up. And I went and talked to my manager, told him that not only was I offended, but many people were going to be offended. And he effectively told me to shut up and go back to work, ignore it.
Sean Vina says his criticism wasn't well received. He was sent home. Today, a local NAACP officer came to take a look for herself.
What would it be like if that was a Nazi flag up there for the Jews who live in this area? Would they permit that to happen? Absolutely not. So then why should we?
Moviegoers seem to take a mixed view. This couple returned their pre-purchase tickets.
I'm furious now that I really am because I don't see where it's supposed to represent me.
This college history major found the mural odd but not offensive.
Well, I think since it has both flags, it shouldn't be seen as an offensive thing because it does have both the Union flag and the Confederate flag. So if they are going for history, I just don't really get how it goes with a movie theater.
But the controversy was quickly put to rest by the movie co-manager. When News 4 asked about the mural, Chris Knox said the Chatterbox Lounge has an historical theme featuring old Fredericksburg photos, some from the Civil War. With its two flags, the mural was intended to reflect the ultimate union between North and South. Knox says they never meant to offend.
We feel horrible about it. Was not our intent whatsoever was to offend anybody. In fact, what we're going to do is we're going to change the banner that we came up with. Our artist kind of came up with that drawing. He'd done a lot of things around here. And we're going to change it to a Virginia flag. So, you know, still kind of tells the story a little bit, the history.
As for the employee who called attention to the flags, his ultimate fate is still unknown. He says he hopes he still has a job when he comes back to work later this week. Julie Carey, News 4, Fredericksburg.